Listening Library presents Arthur and the Lost Diary, Book Number 9, by Marc Brown. Read by Mark Linn-Baker.
Arthur and the Lost Diary by Marc Brown. Chapter Book 9. Chapter 1. It was a busy afternoon at the library. Lots of people were wandering about, choosing books or doing research. At one table, Sue Ellen was sitting alone. She didn't look up when anyone walked by, nor did she pay any attention to passing conversations. She was concentrating on writing in her diary. Dear Diary, the library is a crowded place today. A lot of my friends are here working on school projects. Sometimes I think it's funny that I have so many different kinds of friends. I wonder sometimes why I'm friends with them and not with other people. If I could make up some new friends, what kind would I want? Should they be friends who always give me presents or volunteer to clean up my room? Or maybe I'd like famous friends who star in TV shows or movies. What makes someone a real friend, anyway? Sue Ellen put down her pen. That was enough for now. She loved having a diary, a special place to write down her private thoughts. It wasn't that her ideas were always great or important, but she liked putting the words on paper where she could look at them. She closed the diary and traced the edge of the binding with her finger. Sue Ellen had designed the cover herself. "My Diary," she had printed neatly with a sparkle pen. Underneath, she had added "Private" and "Do Not Open" in large letters. The library clock struck 4 times, reminding Sue Ellen that it was time to go. She picked up all the books she wanted to check out and piled them on her school notebook and diary. She tucked everything underneath her arm as she walked to the circulation desk. She had to shift her arm to stay balanced, and when she did, her diary slipped out of the pile and fell silently onto the carpet. Ms. Turner sat at the checkout counter, waiting to help people with their books. She smiled when she saw Sue Ellen. "That's an impressive pile. I see you're going to be reading a lot this week." "I couldn't make up my mind," Sue Ellen admitted. "There were so many good books to choose from." As Ms. Turner began checking out the books, Sue Ellen spread them on the counter. When she got to the last one, she expected to see her diary underneath. But all she saw was her notebook. Immediately, she searched among the other books. "Is anything wrong?" asked Ms. Turner. "No, I don't think... well, yes." Sue Ellen looked around the floor. All she saw were 2 paper clips and a pencil eraser. "I think I lost something," she said. Quickly, she retraced her steps to the table where she had been sitting. The diary wasn't there. Where could it have gone? Diaries don't disappear like magic, and they don't walk away by themselves. She knelt down and searched under the chairs and tables, pushing aside feet when she had to.
"Excuse me. Ouch! Watch my fingers! Coming through!"
Sue Ellen searched everywhere she could remember walking, and also a few places she hadn't. She even looked through the wastebaskets. But it was no good. The diary was nowhere to be found. Chapter 2. Sue Ellen dragged herself back to the checkout counter. Her face was red and her eyes watery.
"What's wrong?" asked Ms. Turner, who could see that Sue Ellen was upset.
"I lost my diary. I had it a minute ago. I don't understand. I must have left it here."
She scanned the counter again.
"But I guess I didn't."
"Books don't get lost in my library," Ms. Turner assured her. "Describe it to me."
Sue Ellen took a deep breath.
"Well, it kind of looks like a book. It has a shiny red leather cover. Well, at least it looks like leather. And there are some gold sparkle letters that say, 'My Diary.' And under that I wrote, 'Private. Do not open.'"
"That's very specific," said Ms. Turner. "It should make our search easier. Don't worry.
We'll find it. I'll tell everyone on the staff to be on the lookout.
Thanks. I guess I'll keep looking myself. I just wish...
Sue Ellen paused because she heard some laughing. It was exactly the kind of sound a girl might make if she was looking at a secret diary.
I'll be back, she told Ms. Turner.
Sue Ellen traced the sound to the corner where Francine was hunched over some pages.
So that's where it went, said Sue Ellen.
She marched up to the desk.
Pretty funny, huh, Francine?
Francine nodded.
I'll say, listen to this. I don't have to listen to it, said Sue Ellen. I wrote it.
She snatched the book away from Francine.
Hey! And there's nothing funny about stealing someone's diary. I'm surprised at you, Francine. I thought you were my...
Sue Ellen looked down at the book. It was red, but it didn't have gold sparkle letters.
Hey, this isn't my diary.
Of course not, said Francine.
It's a joke book. What would I be doing with your diary? I don't know. You could have picked it up. It's red and says private on it. I had it a minute ago, and now it's gone.
How mysterious, said Francine. Do you think it was stolen? Sue Ellen didn't know what to think.
It was only valuable to me. I've been writing in it forever.
I've never had a diary, said Francine.
What do you write in it? My ideas, what's happened during the day, private thoughts. It's very important that I find it, Francine. I mean, there's stuff in there about everyone.
Francine's eyes opened wide.
Everyone? When you say everyone, you mean everyone? Yes, yes, but that's not what matters now.
It matters to me, said Francine.
What have you been writing? I can't talk about that now. I have to find my diary.
Before Francine could say anything more, Sue Ellen rushed off. If she didn't find the diary soon, she didn't know what she would do. Chapter 3.
What's wrong with Sue Ellen?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.